Place emergency.
Police emergency.
Police, you're South Yorkshire Police. How can I help?
When crisis strikes. These are the people we call for.
Whoa, whoa.
Oh dear.
Oh wow.
The ones who see us.
What?
As we really are.
Fluffy bum, all that for you are.
There's no need for abusive Fluffy language.
Bum. Put your arse away. Go on, put it away.
Oh, he's just got another me again for sex. Talking dirty again.
Herbert.
I still look at things and go, wow. Can't believe I've just seen that.
Yeah, on the floor now! Give me
these are the officers.
Get back!
Working on Britain's front line.
Anything could change at a split second.
Move out of the way!
Are you one of them?
And that's our job.
In a year that's tested us all.
Shops are going bare. We're living in a crisis now.
Times have changed. We've all changed. The whole country has been affected.
Go on, check him. Nobody feels safe anymore.
They are the ones we turn to. More and more.
Are you all right, chicken?
You don't need to be scared. Where are you?
Let's get you up.
It's okay.
Hey, we've all been there.
We stand together as a family, brothers and sisters, all on that thin blue line.
Emergency.
Are we ready for another cup of tea yet? I think I am.
It's 3:30 in the afternoon.
Is it an ongoing problem with them?
And while staff at South Yorkshire Police have just started a new shift...
Right, okay.
It's not strong enough.
Across the region, schools are out for the day.
Police emergency.
Hi, basically, this girl, I've had an argument with for ages. The things that she said to me and my mum, just don't like it. She's been saying to me, like, well, at least my dad hasn't left me and stuff.
Every weekday, at about this time, calls about kids being tormented start to come in.
I feel sick. I genuinely didn't feel sick.
Police emergency? When you take calls from children being picked on, It upsets you, you know? It definitely upsets you.
And he's calling me names and stuff like that, and I don't want to be called names. I've had enough.
When they're reporting something that's really impacted on them.
No, I don't want to live like this.
No. Okay. All right, love. There's always that one kid at school that, you know, just makes your life hell. It's something that you grow up with, isn't it? Just stay safe for tonight, and we'll get some officers to come front morning. I remember one particular boy made me feel, you know, tiny, and there's times when you just don't want to go to school and it makes your life a misery, really. It's horrible.
In South Yorkshire and across the UK, bullying in schools is on the rise.
It's incident 29, okay?
All right, thank you.
All right, well, thank you.
With a quarter of young people admitting to having been victimised.
Whether it's a bit of teasing, a bit of name-calling, or whether it's violent, I think everyone's experienced it on some level.
Police emergency.
I want to see if you could come out, please. My daughter's been paid up by a car officer and glad to film it.
All right, love you. How old's your daughter?
13.
I was bullied from primary school all the way up to the end of secondary school.
And what's happened then? Have they all just started on her?
They're going out for a kitchen and pulled her there and everything.
Does she know these people?
Well, she was standing around with two of them.
I always had the jokes, oh, you'd be so much prettier if, you know, you just weren't fat.
She got any visible injuries?
It's just her face looks a bit red.
Is it?
Oh, it affected everything. I didn't want to talk to people. I didn't want to approach people.
She just stopped staying in the bedroom. When she comes out from school, she was in the bedroom. At weeping, she was in the bedroom.
Bless her.
And I worry that the amount of calls that we receive about bullying probably still doesn't reflect how much it goes on.
Will you both be in all evening this evening, lovey, and get some officers to come out to see you?
Yeah,
I will be. Fabulous.
From the calls I've taken, it's definitely getting worse. The level of violence that you hear about, the maliciousness of it, it's scary.
South Yorkshire Police, can I help?
Can I please come in the police, please, in the park? It's too much children fighting.
It's 6 p.m. on Friday, and another worrying call involving children is coming in.
How many people? A big boy, a little bit small.
two boys have been fighting.
Yeah, yeah. Is my daughter here? Hello?
Hello?
When they were fighting the little boy, yeah?
Yeah.
He was crying. And then we told him that we're calling the police and they run away.
Right. I'm going to get some officers to come and have a look round, all right? See if we can find him.
Third party's called it in. Kids fighting in Page Hall.
Within minutes, PC's Pete Butler and Chris Shepherd are dispatched to the scene.
Happens all the time. Schoolyard stuff that's got out of hand. It does spill out and into the streets.
7-2 Tango to control, work code 6 for Far Road.
I've got two little girls. They're 6 and my eldest daughter turned 8 yesterday. And even at their age, they've both had spats with the friends at school and then the friends again. But as they get older, it gets more and more sinister, and I hope that doesn't happen.
Hey! Jump out.
Driver, what's going on?
Hold him.
What's going on? Sit down on the floor. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down on the floor. What's happened? Listen, can you hear what I'm saying? Do you know him personally or do you just know him?
No. Being first on the scene, you can't do everything all at once.
Have you guys seen what's happened?
Because if it's any... Your main priority is making sure that victim is safe.
Probably about a 15-year-old male. He looks to be in shock at the moment. He can't speak to us. He's got a nice lump to the side of his temple.
Okay, have we got an ambulance coming?
I've asked for one, yeah.
A request is made for urgent ambulance support.
Does anybody know who this lad is? What's his name? Ahmed.
He's slipping in and out of consciousness at the moment.
But dispatch is unable to give an ETA. Yeah.
Has anybody here witnessed this? Anybody seen what's happened? No? Right, if you haven't seen what's happened, you've got no to do with it, you need to leave. This lad on four. It could potentially be quite serious. It could be looking at, you know, brain injury, spinal injuries. It could turn into a crime scene. Can you keep away, please? Thank you. And then you've got all these people who've got absolutely no concept of the fact they might be destroying evidence. Guys, keep moving, please. There's nothing for you to see. And there's people smiling and laughing, think it's funny. And they're pulling the camera phones out. That part of it makes me angry.
Guys! Have you got anything to offer to this incident? Yes or no? Go away then.
Feel sick at all? Yeah, a little bit sick.
You weren't knocked out or anything like that, were you? No.
You look really, really dazed when we got here.
Yeah.
Do you have any idea why this has happened?
No, this guy beat me up and then my brother came and they all started beating me up. So
they were picking on you? And your brothers come to help you and they've all turned on it?
There was like 12 of them. They're always bullying me every single time I go to the shop. They were surrounding me. They said, give me your money and your stuff.
Where's your pain? In your leg?
One of them, but he was only a little kid. He said, I'll kill your mum. And then they all started laughing. And then my brother got angry. And then one of them chipped him over. They started kicking him and punching him.
Have they stamped on your leg? Body slammed you onto your back.
They got a stick or something and smashed it in his head and hit him in the leg and stamped in his head 2 or 3 times.
18 minutes for ambulance. You're right, Ahmed. Try and keep your eyes open for us, buddy. Are you feeling sleepy at all?
When you've got a 15-year-old sparked out in the street, that's not kids being kids. That's really serious.
Your mum's coming down now. Our colleagues are bringing your mum down, okay?
If we ever had a fight when I was young, it was more sort of like pulling at clothing and pushing each other. That these days, they just don't stop. It's kind of real feral mentality.
Your mum's here now, Ahmed. We've got an ambulance travelling for him. It's been set up on by a group of lads.
Ahmed may not come in. Waiting for him, this 7 o'clock, he's not coming. I'm getting scared. And the police knocked the door for me. All my body shaking. Oh my God, like a fire in my body. Yeah, I see my children die.
We're just waiting for the ambulance.
I can't take my children out. I don't know what can I do. My son is going to school. The children take your money away. You have nothing in your hand. Ahmed very scared. Why? Because this is not first one or the second one, you see? All time like that. You kids all time bullying, you see?
And you know your troubles,
it says, and unlike Muslim people, why should I shit? This is not your country. All time, my children are coming to buy something.
After physical appearance, ethnicity is the most common reason for bullying in children.
I grew up in Sudan. No school, no food. My children, I don't want to get like me, you see? And something good, yeah, and get good life. Very hard.
By the time an ambulance arrives...
We've got a 15-year-old kid who's been attacked, he's been stamped on the head.
Ahmed has been on the ground for 30 minutes.
But his eyes were rolling to the top of his head, yeah. He was very pale, he didn't look like... He was very conscious.
It's not going to feel very nice, but it's just going to protect your neck.
Yes, yes, Dad's with us. Mum's just heading back to the address.
I don't really know why people bully people. Could be that they want to make themselves feel better by making somebody else feel worse, make themselves feel more powerful. Why would you want to do that? What benefit would you get from just causing somebody misery for no reason?
With paramedics concerned about a possible head injury, Ahmed is taken to the nearest children's hospital, 15 minutes away.
Traumatic being knocked to the ground, stabbed to the chest, got some bruising and raising to the right side.
Yeah, kids can be really cruel. They generally don't think about the consequences of what they're doing. They've not lived enough to learn about consequences. They've picked him up and thrown him on the floor.
And then they've stamped on his head and kicked him and anything like that. Yeah.
People die from getting punched once. Happens all the time. They don't get it.
His knee is not broken, is it? It
doesn't look. We don't think so. We'll get an X-ray just to make sure, but I don't think he's got like four limb-threatening injuries.
That's fine.
That's what we need to know, isn't it?
Yes, that is what we need to know. Thank you very much.
That's the phrase. That's the exact phrase.
It's not just physical injuries that someone will face. Incidents like these can impact the victim massively. They can be scared to even walk out on the streets anymore. The aftermath can be devastating.
Are you feeling any better, Ahmed? Do you know any of these lads that have done this to you?
No. I know every time when I see him very upset, I see him sitting alone in your house, not eating, not drinking. Yeah, and my heart gets broken, you see. I can't hold myself. All the time I cry myself, yani. I don't know what to say, really. I don't like people that hit my children. It's all the time broken my heart.
There's hopefully some CCTV that have caught it, but I need to get that looked into. So I'm going to see if it captures it. We're going to crime it, and we'll contact you. Okay. Probably tomorrow or the day after to see if I can find anything for you. Okay. No worries.
Thank you so much. You're welcome. You're very welcome.
Father said, you don't need to fight, but you can reason with them and be friends with them. But we tried to reason with them, but they don't listen.
Ahmed, we'll speak to you soon, okay, mate?
Thank you. Feel better soon, mate. All right. Good lad.
They think that they're better than everyone else and they have respect of everyone, but really they don't have respect for themselves.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Do you want a drink? My name's Jess. Yeah. Do you want...
The staff in the South Yorkshire Police 999 emergency control room typically work four 12-hour shifts a week.
South Yorkshire Police, how can we help?
Long enough to get to know one another.
OK. We all tend to get on with each other, mostly.
Police emergency, Jess speaking.
Some people more than others would get on my nerves.
Hello, it's Jess.
Not a lot of people can deal with Josh.
Thank you, bye.
That's what you sound like.
Banter is always a backwards and forwards thing, isn't it? Until someone doesn't take it as banter anymore.
She's calling me a bully.
I think everyone in the call centre mostly would have a thick skin because obviously most calls we take, it's not a laughing and joking kind of job. So if every single thing was to upset you, then you you wouldn't be able to do the job. And I just think it's the person's intention, so whether they are just doing it to have fun with someone.
Get off me.
Or if they're actually meaning to hurt their feelings and be nasty.
It's 6:30 on Sunday evening.
Police communications, can I help?
I've rang numerous times this past week and I've got trouble again with local youth outside my property. They're throwing big bricks at the window and they're trying to break in.
It's the sixth call in the past week police have received from a woman who is having trouble with a group of teenagers.
I think it's because I'm a woman what lives on my own. They're provoking me more, you know.
Right, just take a deep breath. Going to get officers out to you. Okay. Just keep on the phone to me.
PCs Liam Woodward and Kirsty Smith are dispatched to Kimberworth, an estate on the outskirts of Rotherham.
She lives in a flat in Flotsam Shops. It's an ongoing ambulance issue, this.
Are you still there, lovely?
Yeah.
Come on, don't be upset, sweetheart.
You're going to leave me alone.
I know.
Fire's place.
Officers are outside. Yeah, they are. They're buzzing, you look like.
All right
then, no worries.
Thank you.
Bye. I'm here about an incident you've just rang in.
It's every day.
The stones at a window. They're threatening her. These are between like 14 and 16 year old, and you're not doing all about it.
Tell them what's happened tonight.
They're throwing old bricks at the window and they're trying to break in downstairs. This one
this
in my
window.
Bedroom.
Okay.
I open windows, so please leave me alone, give me a break. It ricocheted and hit me in the eye, that's why I've got a black eye there.
For this lady, it must be hell on earth. Everyone says that your home is your castle, but when you don't feel safe in your home environment, where else is there to go?
And have you got any support around here?
Just my brother and my mum.
They know where she lives. They're in a local community. For her, it must feel like there is no way out.
When did it start?
I don't know, about 3 months ago, if that. Just
and
started.
They're picking on everyone.
Yeah, but it seems like more so me.
Some people might say they're just kids, they've got nothing else to do, but it's a fine line between being a bored teenager and becoming a bully. And I think their behaviour is bullying.
She'll look out the window and that's it. Boom, I'm giving them ammunition then, aren't I?
They're picking a target and they're aiming for a reaction. That's bullying. You're constantly pushing until that person explodes.
You don't care. You don't. And I've been doing this now for fun, yeah, every night. You don't.
I do.
They'll always look for the weakest in the pack, the one with vulnerabilities that has no way out, and that becomes harassment.
Heading out into the estate, PC Woodward quickly identifies four potential suspects.
Right, there's four lads stood outside my calls. Can you ID as any of them?
Yep.
Yeah, it's them. In with cool and black coat on, do you look? Them.
Yeah,
that's
them. Here.
Is it them? Is it them ones?
Yeah, she's saying it's them.
Right, all right, lads, where have you been tonight? Just got here. Anyone who can prove that where you've been, we've had a complaint that you guys have been ID'd for throwing stones at a flat. Whereabouts do you live? Local?
I don't have a good
time. Well, you do, buddy, at the minute, because you're all detained. What do you do?
You can check all cameras, you've got the deal.
That's fine, buddy, at the minute, I'm going to be taking your names and addresses. Date of birth?
1997.
Don't be clever. Respect for the police has gone, especially with the younger generation, and very, very anti-police.
Is it a grey coat with blue on top?
It's a grey puffer jacket with a blue hood.
That's it.
That's him.
Yeah, that's him.
Right, at this point, you're under arrest for criminal damage acts. So, in my army defence, you're not mentioning when questioned, so which you may later rely on in court.
What are you doing?
Wait,
what? I've not done all wrong.
They're saying that they're not done anything, pleading their innocence, which young lads usually do. Yeah, can the male come out and ID him? Because he's been there.
Can you go outside?
ID him?
Yeah.
You're mad! What, and get more shit from him?
There is a chance for him face to face that you can make matters worse. But we were desperate to try and solve this bullying issue as it's been ongoing for weeks.
Because I won't fucking live here, that's not fair! We just said it is him, what more do you need?
Well,
What's that got all to do, man?
Because he's been accused of an offence.
Yeah, but just get him out and fucking...
He's not willing to come down because of what's gone on. Unless you catch these kids in the act, you're going to have a hard time dealing with the issues that are ongoing. A lot of the time, as soon as they see a police car, as soon as they hear sirens, lights, the kids starburst.
It's the, yeah, it's fucking, we aren't even done. No, how can you prove it, son? How can you get us done?
Ask them to come to the window, mate. We're a bit closer. If they can ID, please.
Whoa!
Got runners, mate. Like, I have 15 years more on age-wise and obviously a bit heavier. I don't think I were ever going to catch that young lad.
Roger, thank you.
They want to chase off your... They think it's a game.
They said,
like a rite of passage or somewhere.
Unfortunately, often this behaviour, it just escalates and escalates. That's low level, such as bullying, and then chucking bricks at a window, which becomes criminal damage.
And what I do is, I'm going to put forms in to the council to try and get you moved.
Then they've started to try and gain access into a property, which becomes burglary.
I'm going to put onto the council to come replace the window as well. Do I recommend that tonight she maybe stays with you or mum or somewhere safe?
I'm going to stay here.
Or you stop here, just so she's not on her own.
And that's why I think it's important to break the cycle of bullying as young as possible.
I'm sorry that you're having to put up with this. I really am.
Don't make me ruin again.
But police can't break the cycle on their own.
The kid who's run off is definitely involved. I got hold of him at one point and I've gone to cuff him because he won't give me his name. But to be fair, the young lads,
How old are they like?
They'd have been about 16 to 18.
Oh dear.
South Yorkshire Police, you all right?
Yes. This particular evening, I've had four youths who seem to think it's quite funny to stand at the door shaking it and banging on it and shouting abuse for no reason at all. So I had to lock the door.
We get calls from people all the time, the same people, you know, the repeat callers reporting, you know, harassment from groups of kids.
Police emergency.
Hey, I've got someone kicking the door again.
But again?
Yeah, it happened all last night, it's happening again.
Is anyone else in the house with you?
Yeah, me and your girlfriend.
Hiya.
Hiya.
It starts picking on the weak kid at school. They never pick on the popular kids, do they? It's always the ones that seem to be weak in some way. Then once they're out of school, they have nothing to do, so if you're not going to pick on a weak child, they're just going to then start picking on people who are obviously weak in the community.
Do you know who it is?
No idea. It's just torturing us now, you know what I mean?
These bullies just seem to find them, seek them out, and just want to make their lives hell. It's a coward's way, isn't it?
Running weren't really conducive and weren't part of my plan tonight.
Communities aren't what they used to be. A lot of people just keep themselves to themselves now, keep their heads down and become blind to what's going on, even though it is causing issues.
Are we up to, lads? Don't go up to green, there's ongoing issues, so stay away.
Myself, I'm from an old mining village. Everybody used to know each other. That slowly has broken down. It can only be the same in these communities, which used to be close. They used to look out for each other. Now that's not there. And bullying can be lethal. It only takes the wrong person at the wrong time, that wrong person in crisis, that they feel like there's no way out and take their own life, or they think, right, I'm going to take this into my own hands to make a situation irreparable.
Police emergency.
My son's got a knife and he's threatening to stab himself. Stop it, please. Please, stop it.
Police emergency.
Hello. Could I have somebody out, please? My son's got a knife and he's threatening to stab himself.
Right, is he with you now?
Yes, he's got blood all over him. Stephen, please stop it.
It's 7 o'clock on Thursday evening.
Please stop it.
I've requested an ambulance already, don't worry.
And an ambulance is called for a suicidal 27-year-old man.
He's still got the knife in his hand, he won't put it down. Stephen, stop it, please.
We've got officers travelling to you, all right? Just try and keep him talking.
But because a knife is involved...
Keep going straight.
Yeah.
It falls to PC Kirsty Smith and Special Constable Carlos Rea to secure the scene before paramedics will attend.
Stop it.
People think we go to burglaries and lock bad men up, but it's very slim, that part of our job. A lot of our jobs have just been mental health jobs.
Right.
I probably go to a call every day. It's really sad. And if it wasn't for us, a lot of people would lose their lives.
Yeah, I'm just blocking
the room. I'm sorry, I'm not talking to her.
Officer
there, but they should be with you any second.
Chair 2,
that officer's in a position.
Let it
go up to see if
he
goes stand 6. May come away and put the interval report
with my intention.
Chair 2,
need to schedule a foot. Stop there. Shut the door, quick. Rest in order then, thank you. Hello, Macy. What's your name?
Steve.
Yeah. Sorry?
Steve.
What's happening today, Steve?
What are you doing with that?
Alright, thank you.
Give me the knife.
No, please stop it. Help.
Right, I'm just
going to
clean it, alright?
It might sting. He does have quite a few cuts, and we need to bandage him up.
Where's the knife gone?
Yeah,
it's gone now.
We got on there?
It's the problem we have. If he refuses to go to the hospital, we don't have any power to remove him from his own home. Ambulance can force him to go, we can't.
What's happened today? Why do you want to tie himself with a knife?
What have you got on your mind? You're fed up of working? So it's a case of making common ground with him and persuading him that he really needs some help.
What do you do?
Pot washing.
Just
take the piss out of you because you're pot washing.
Who takes the piss out of you?
I used to be a prison negotiator in a previous job, and I kind of use it, really, in this job every single day.
You've got loads of people that love you. Don't let one person that's bullying you at work spoil it.
I think my hearing affects my job as well, you know, because I'm partially impaired. Feel like they're laughing and taking the piss out of me.
I'm sure they're not. It's nothing to laugh about, is it?
When I got me into work, there'd be a lot of laughing, and they were, like, ganging up. All they ever did was laugh at me, not with me.
Sorry, we've got to put pressure on it.
I just felt lonely. I didn't know who to talk to. I'm just the odd one out.
I wanted this to work out tonight. I wanted to cut myself. I wanted to just end it.
Just got to one day where I just thought, I don't want to be here no more.
It worked.
That's not
so much. Stephen's colleagues, it first of all would have been banter and a joke to them. But there is a fine line between banter and then it becoming bullying. And they've crossed the line to the point where Stephen feels really victimised from what they're saying. And even though they maybe don't mean it, he feels it.
Sorry, we've got to put pressure on it.
Because of my hearing, as a child, there was a lot of picking on me. Go to school, get your bag took off, you get your books thrown about and get pushed into walls. You could go and get your lunch and then they just knock the tray out of your hand. The thing that scared me the most is, you know when you get that, well, I'll see you after school or I'll see you in the car park or we'll be waiting for you. It's like, instead of going a certain way to get on the bus, I'd have to go a different way. I had a hearing aid and it just came to the point that, because I was bullied that much, I just stood on it and I thought, I'm not wearing that again.
Government statistics show that young people with disabilities are twice as likely to experience bullying.
I think words always hurt you, to be honest. I think when you get injured, you repair a lot of the time. It's not forever, whereas I think once you're mentally scarred, it's very hard to get rid of it. I was bullied when I was younger at school. You can feel very low and worthless. Like, everyone's going to pick on you for the rest of your life, no matter where you are, because you've experienced it before.
This is the second time in a month that I've actually tried to end my life, and you stopped me. Why are you doing it?
Because people care for you, mate.
Among victims of bullying in the UK, 27% have self-harmed and 33% have experienced suicidal thoughts.
Right, come on then, let's get you to the hospital.
You can't keep doing this. Keeping it all locked up inside, it just builds up. I think it's best to talk to people, don't hide things inside all the time. Make sure you tell people how you feel.
I'm just going to shut this door, Stephen, so just watch yourself.
I don't think bullies realise how much their actions affect victims.
Right, people have problems and they find this way to solve it. Sad.
Until someone dies, I don't think they actually even think about what they're doing or how they're making anyone feel, because they're just thinking about themselves. In Stephen's case, he needed someone to be kind to him, and that was us.
Who's murdered her?
Hiya, what is my partner's been at work today and he's had some trouble with a girl at work, calling me off, I'm a little man, etc.
In a recent survey, a quarter of employees reported being bullied in the workplace.
For like an argument at work, it's gone a bit far, to be honest.
Doctor, please.
Hey, I'm boiling, you know, I'm trying to go to sleep. He won't go out of my bedroom, he won't leave me alone, he's just constantly following me around the house.
But for some, home is not a sanctuary either.
I mean, I went out of a weekend. I've got absolutely hundreds of messages on my phone calling me a tramp.
Think he's been in any way controlling or jealous?
Extremely.
In the last year, South Yorkshire Police received more than 34,000 calls about adults in abusive relationships.
Really, bullying is abuse. It's abuse towards their own children, other family members, their partners.
It's police here. We've had a call from a concerned party who has told us that you've rung them. What's going on?
I'm fine, I haven't banged any buttons. I'm alright.
And some people can't get out of that.
What's happened?
I just had a bit of a domestic.
Where's he gone?
I think he's just falling back up.
Often, people don't actually realise that they're in one of these relationships because it's constant and it's always there.
Doesn't matter, it's fine, I don't know who's called you.
Officers are on the way.
Why are they on way when they have called for him?
You can hear the fear in their voice and the timidness. You almost can hear them thinking, am I doing the right thing?
No, I am all right. Well, I am close.
I know what you're saying, but you don't sound it, so we're going to come and check, OK?
All right, thank you.
Bye.
And they become used to being abused, and it will only get worse. Lord knows how difficult it must be, but it needs to stop.
South Yorkshire Police, how can I help you?
Hello, hi. There's an argument going on, or fight between a man and a woman.
It's just before 7 on Saturday night.
Can you still see them? Were they in the street?
Yeah, they're still there. They're in the front garden. He had us against the bush.
And officers are alerted to another domestic incident.
Right, OK. Yeah. All right, we'll get someone down to find out what's happening then.
Stat 6, can we get an exact location, please?
PC Ryan Everett is sent to investigate.
I'm guessing it's the set of working outside. Hello, my love. I'm in the right place, I'm assuming I am. Oh, yeah, I'm Ryan, I'm from police. Is this your house? Shall we go inside and have a chat?
Officers arrive to discover a distraught female.
Inside this house? No, it's just you, yeah?
But the male has fled the scene.
Right, let's see what's happening. Just take a minute. Get a breath.
Me and his partner.
Yeah.
We just thought we'd just meet up and see what's
going on. Have you both agreed to that?
Yeah,
right, okay.
It's like, that is changed.
Alright, okay.
And then we started going wrong.
Yeah. It was obvious, she was very scared. And from my experience, it's very difficult
to get that information out, a potential victim of domestic violence.
He's not been kicking off, he's not been doing nothing.
Especially being a male police officer, to find it hard to trust.
Forgive me for saying this, you seem very shaky and upset, which is my concern. Is this because you've had an argument? Or has it been physical with you?
It's me, like, I'm very anxious.
Okay, yeah.
And you had to sit down and gain that trust. Talk to her, console her, explain what we can do to offer to help.
Take your time. All right. Forgive me for asking these questions because it's the first time I've met you. So I'm just trying to get a picture of what's happening.
A few minutes, 5-10 minutes, bit by bit, she'll pass in more and more information on to us.
We've come out and then we've had a re-argument up here.
Don't mind me asking, what have you been arguing about?
Listen, you can't come here. I can't let you sleep okay. here for me because we're not supposed to have no contact about that.
He's
in court on second.
What's he in court for?
Double.
Right, so he's got conditions not to.
Yeah,
exactly. I'm assuming he's got some sort of condition.
Mean,
yeah, and this is what.
This is what the argument's been today because he's been like, he's seen me and he wants to come home. And I'm like, he can't come home.
Victims were being subjected to bullying, domestic violence, controlling, coercive behaviour, having that repetitive emotional abuse day to day. To me, it's a form of torture.
Grabbed you again today. Have a look. Yeah.
It just pushed me to push.
There's no retreat. There's no rest for our victims. They're trapped in their own home. They've got no control of their life at all. It's a very controlling way of bullying. It's making that person feel worthless.
Anyone you was with him, how would you describe the relationship?
He's being more controlling because he's more paranoid.
Very controlling, in your words.
But it's like when I went out with my friends, like it'd be constantly texting me. No, my money is all gone. Just keep him up.
Coercive control has been the crime from 2015. Since then, I see a lot more victims coming forward now and talking to us. It's getting more recognised, and they are being brave and they are disclosing. So we can do something about it.
Absolutely correct. I need to speak to him. And I won't lie to you, he needs to be arrested, all right? Because he's breaching, he's assaulting you. But that's not your decision, that's my decision.
Right, let's get out there and try and find him. Okay. You've got to lock this door behind us.
The suspect left on foot over half an hour ago.
We're going off in that direction, but whether he's come out of chapel or what.
Outside,
yeah. Yeah.
But officers believe he's still in the area.
We did get information from our victim that this male does, on a daily basis, carry a Stanley knife.
He literally could have popped out in any direction.
In my mind, the risk is very high for the victim and for us.
It's 7:40 on Saturday night. On the streets of Rotherham, PC Ryan Everett is hunting for a man accused of assaulting his ex-girlfriend and believed to be carrying a knife.
The advice we gave this female was to stay in the house, lock the doors. We needed to get him. We needed to detain him, get him off the streets for her benefit and everybody else's.
Just 10 minutes after officers left the victim at her home.
Police emergency.
She calls 999 for help.
He's come back. He's outside now. Yes, received. We're heading back there now.
Has he hurt you? Has he got into the house?
Oh, but he's not making
a ringing. Please! Stop there! Get down! You're under arrest. Stay down! Stop resisting! Hey! Stop there!
Wait there!
Do you want it, man?
Watch my wrist! Yeah, stop kicking at!
Bend your arm!
I'm not resisting!
You're under arrest on suspicion or ABH.
Nice one, pal! I've got a Stanley blade in the back right pocket, but I cut my own fucking wrist with. You know what best thing for me if you'd have just fucking left me on the bus on a fucking tree there?
Yeah, but we don't want that though, do we?
Oh, don't you want that? No. It's gonna fuck you whether you like it or not, innit? There's some people that you could just go and fucking deal with. Some people that you just go and fucking help.
Well, we can get you some help.
We had 5 minutes, 10 minutes with him. Several officers, handcuffs, restraints, cages.
By the time I wake up, I'm not going to fucking remember this in the first place. So what's the point?
But our victims had to deal with that 24/7.
What's the point?
For us to intervene, it is so important to break that cycle, the extreme bullying, that repetitive emotional abuse. And this is why I joined the job, to deal with them.
The 21-year-old male is taken to Shepcott Lane Custody Centre in Sheffield.
He's been arrested at 19:40 today. Said that they've helped me coming from this female from inside the property. He's grabbed hold of her, causing bruising into her arm, and he's then pushed her into a bush as well, and it's caused cuts to her arm. Necessity being to prevent further harm and to prevent further harm to himself as well.
Right. Not too bad, Diego. Not too bad.
So, do you understand why you're here? I'm going to authorise your detention so that you can stay with us. I can interview you about what's going off, okay?
Yeah.
Do you like a solicitor whilst you're here? Okay. Do I need to tell anybody that you're here at the minute?
I just want to let no one that I'm here. All my family's are handling this, so don't let no shit.
Okay.
Don't let no shit from me.
When dealing with people like our suspect, it makes you wonder what kind of upbringing they've had, what kind of environment they've lived in, what they've seen, to think this is a norm.
It's going to start booking on our system. My colleagues just need to search and put any of your property on the desk. All right.
You've searched me about 3 fucking 4 times.
We haven't searched your feet, have we?
And if you don't, I could just turn my neck on and you fucking don't fuck up, would you? Really? Yeah?
To threaten police officers, to try and lash out, to hit women, be violent towards their partners. What's happening in their life to make them think that's normal behaviour?
Fuck yeah. I know I've got some damage working for you.
Are they a victim of bullying and they're passing on to the nearest and dearest?
Were you born in Rotherham?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm ashamed to say, but yeah.
We don't just offer support measures for our victims. Once we get a suspect in custody, which is a place of safety for him, we do our referrals for them as well.
And what's your current address, buddy?
Current address, I ain't got one. I've been homeless since I was about 13, 14.
Okay.
Get some intervention in custody with him from other agencies, see what can help him to try and break that cycle as well.
Have you had anything to drink today, mate? No? No alcohol at all? Any drugs?
I've had one smoke recently.
Sometimes we take calls from suspects and they'll ring and they'll say, I've just hit my girlfriend or I've just hit my boyfriend. And they'll talk to you and they'll say, I'm just angry. I don't know why I've done it. I'm just angry.
But what's playing in bringing family up when you're other people? You've got some kind of family involved.
It all stems from being angry because it's about processing what you've dealt with. And if people don't have the chance to deal with that, it will escalate.
All right, so we're going, guys, to number 3.
They might love this person and they care for him, but because they haven't dealt with their own shit, it bleeds. It bleeds into every part of your life.
When I've been bullied in the past, it's made you feel very low and worthless, and you feel like there's something wrong with you and you want to be like the people that are bullying you. I don't want to feel like that again. So if I make someone else feel like that, I'll feel like the bully did when they did it to me.
At the same time as being bullied by people who were my friends, I've lashed out at other people and it's embarrassing. It's embarrassing to think that being bullied, that I've added to that, and I've bullied people. I've laughed when people have made jokes, or I've made jokes and I've sniggered and I've joined in, and that's bullying. No one's saying you can't have your own opinions, but when it's targeted and it's on purpose and it's to upset people, it's bullying.
What would you like to see change?
I just want people to be nice to each other.
What's going on? Hold him. What's going on?
The bullies who attacked Ahmed were not apprehended. But there's been no more trouble since the night he was taken to hospital.
Throwing all bricks at a window.
No suspects were charged in the case of the woman harassed by youths. She has since moved out of the area.
Stop kicking her!
Found guilty of battery and possession of cannabis, and received a community order with a 6-week curfew and must attend a rehabilitation program. He is prohibited from contacting his ex and cannot go to the area where she lives for 12 months. Since injuring himself with a knife, Stephen is working on turning his life around. He is looking for a new job and a flat of his own.
Now I've hit rock bottom, I'm going to get myself out of the hole that I've made and, you know, stay positive, and I could keep getting tall.
If you've been affected by the issues raised, there's support information available at channel4.com/support. On Thursday, turning a Venetian ballroom into a breathtaking floral wedding reception with billionaire blooms. The brand new series begins at 8, and wedding receptions were once first dates. Fred's here with a new one next.